Hello and welcome to another episode of me painting again. Oh yeah, we're painting again. So I'm feeling a little bit hot. I may have sat outside too long. So I need to do a painting that'll cool me down. What'll cool me down nicely? A waterfall. Yes, painting a waterfall. So what I've done, as you can see on this grey canvas, is I've just quickly sketched in a few areas. There's rock here. Bit of a tree there, and the waterfall there, big rock here, rock formation that we can. We don't have to have it accurate because this is a made up place. So I've got a picture that I've made on Photoshop, slightly out of shot, and used a photo and copyright free photo for the waterfall, but just in case it isn't copyright free, I'm not going to show it on camera. So you got to be tricky, got to be very very serious these days on YouTube. So I'm not going to show it, but I've got it in the corner of my eye, so I'll be using it as reference. But you can always skip to the end of the painting and use the painting as reference if you wish, and if you wanted to paint along with me and you've got something to look at, you've got the finished painting. Right, let me have a look, because I'm going to change things when I paint it. I'm going to change things again. I changed things when I made it on the computer, but then when you paint it you change it again, so it doesn't really matter. What matters is, I'm going to enjoy this one. I've been wanting to do a really good waterfall picture for ages, and I've never really found the right picture. So I thought, you know what, I spent a while learning Photoshop, why don't I just create one? So that's what I've done. So I'll just move my knife . So, just for your information, the canvas was primed with a little bit of grey gesso, and then I've just used chalk to draw the drawing. Okay. Here are all the paints. For some reason, I line the paints up like they're in formation for a battle or something. But anyway, here are all the paints. Burnt umber, ultramarine blue, cerulean blue, cadmium red, cadmium yellow, viridian green, sap green, and yellow ochre, and titanium white. And that's the palette, and don't think I need any other colours. When I look at the painting, I mean the digital painting that I did, there's two colours that I'm querying in my own head. And that's the colour of the water and the colour of the water in shadow, because this area, the water's predominantly in a shadow, where back here it's lighter and then it's shadow and then light again in areas. Oh, it'd be a great place to walk around this wood if it was real. So let's just start throwing paint on there, I think. You know what I might get? Nah, I think it'll be alright. So I want to try and mix the very background colour. A bit of red, I think. A bit of blue. A bit of brown. Let's get some white. Yeah. Not bad. Not bad at all. I think it needs to be a bit brighter and a bit redder to get closer. So I'm going to use my little reference picture to check, cause this might do. just for a bit more blue and red in it, to darken it a little bit. It's always tricky because sometimes I do it too dark and some too light. This isn't far off the colour. Like I said, we're going to change it, so it doesn't matter. I might as well scrub this in. Into my colour, a little bit of blue in it, and I'll leave some of it. So if you're thinking, when you're doing your painting, just grabbed a bit more brown, why draw that in when you're just going to cover it up like this? And it's a good question, isn't it? What's the point in spending that time and effort to get that there and then suddenly it's that green and you just get rid of it. Well, I better answer that one. So what I do is I scrub it in really thin over the top of it, and I don't really need to see it anymore because I've already seen it. I've already calculated where everything is, so when I'm blocking in my colours I need to think about what's going to happen when I put the paint on the canvas. things are going to change very quickly, and then I've got to think of the order of painting as well. That's another thing that I have to think about, the order of, well, I'm putting my dark down, blocking it in, then what about the waterfall? If I put too much dark paint on here, how am I going to get the white to stick on there? It's going to make it a little bit difficult, so then I'd have to do something to make it work. Just getting a bit of white on the old on this. Blend that into there. Just use my finger to blend it away. So you always got to think about your order of doing stuff. Quite important, really, the order of things. Order! I want order here. See how I just went into the misty bit then with the dark, just to change it. Okay, now we need to do a bit of detail on the rock. This is all rock here. There's some different colours. Just grab a bit of yellow ochre, a bit of the cadmium red. Bit of white maybe. What we got there? That's not bad actually. So we've got some rock, so we want to create some rock shapes. Grab a little bit of the umber, change some of it. Over here as well, maybe there's a piece that comes out like that. Because this is quite distant, really. I'm not worried too much about it. Just playing around. Sometimes you get a bit more of the yellow ochre. There's a break in the rock there. So it goes like that. In all kinds of ways. Even create another level there. Adding little bits. Some darker areas. It's not getting as much. Because there's dark areas going to work nicely. Here, because that's where my lighter area is going to be. So I'm always playing that game of light and dark. Strange. I wonder why I've done that. I don't know why I've done that. This should be like, yeah. Don't know why I messed that up. Rock should be there. Right, let's sit back, have a look at that. Yeah, that's quite good. Some interesting areas. So, I'm going to use another brush. So I'm going to grab some white and go into this mix. Maybe get a little bit of blue. I think that's about right. We'll try it anyway. I haven't got much paint on yet. So I'm going to start creating this. Sort of areas where the water's sort of... There, it's a bit brighter. See where the water's falling over. And we've got a really bright area there. Just sit back and look at that. I think I quite like the shape of it. I think I've got the width about right anyway. Just need to be a bit lighter now. I'm going to throw in a little bit of cerulean blue just to brighten it up. Use some of this to get some of this. I want to go even whiter still, really. Mainly on that bit. Splashing down there. Okay. quite getting the thickness of that. What's that a really? That up. Now I want a little bit of warmth on this as well. So we've got a little bit to, I think it needs. Yeah, that's better. Needed that. Some of that dark back in now. Just switch a really dark from light to dark. Then we've got sunlight here in it, and I want that to have a yellow, so I might use a different brush. Disappear a bit. Okay. Now we get a little bit of yellow, a little bit of the pure white. Sunlight to come and smash this waterfall along this side. So I can go loads of paint. That shows up better. And maybe a little bit this. Here. No, I need the blue. I need to put the blue in. Yeah, I like that. So I can get a bit of that in. I just use my finger just to get a exaggerated light. You can really pile the paint up. I think I'll leave it there. Move a little bit. I'll let this go. Just leave that. Right, I need to mix up a water. I need two waters. That's what I got my cerulean blue for, actually. A bit of ultramarine blue and a bit of cerulean blue. A bit of red. That's nice. I always find it surprising how dark I do my colours. I think if I didn't colour check, all my paintings would look like dark caves. You wouldn't be able to see anything. My colours too. Need a tiny bit of this green. That's looking nice. You know when you mix a paint and it almost looks good enough to taste? This blue isn't, looks good enough to taste, but it's close. Yeah, there's a really nice bit just here, and the colour's perfect for it, so I might just bang that in anyway. Just there. There's a touch there as well. And then it goes darker up here. Maybe I can get a bit of this in there. Interesting. I use my background colour. If I throw in my background colour into the mix, you get a nice blue that's perfect. Especially for this area anyway. Could do with a bigger brush than this though. Maybe I don't. Just mixing myself a pile of this blue. I need quite a lot, really. blue, brown, green, red. White. Probably need a bit more white. So I'm using the darks to play with the lights. I don't want this to be all light and I don't want it to be all dark. So you've got to play with the colours to get this sort of effect. And you could say, why don't you use transparent colours? That's a little bit too dark, I think. That's a bit better. Yeah, you can do paintings using transparent colours for water, and it does work really well when you're scrubbing it in, but that's using a white canvas, and if you're scrubbing a paint really thinly that's transparent, you can see through it. Of course, so it can be really useful to do that. Seascapes, I'll have to do one like that. Anyway, for now, I'm going to change that water. See how you can just change things like that? Just change the colour of the water. Brilliant. I'm going to a bit more blue and brown for these areas. A bit darker because you would be able to see through some of it. So, oh yeah, we're just gonna have that going in and then out. Like that. Not darker there. Okay. Wipe my brush. Just seen something cool. I could do a bit of a lighter blue there. Okay, quite like that. I think I'll put a bit of mist over this bit as well. Just make that a bit lighter, really. Okay. This is my best blender brush. When you're painting wet and wet, like I'm doing, you can use your finger to blend away. Right, so we've got that in. Need a new grey. So I'm using brown and blue. Brown and blue, my two colours. So if you want it to be cool, you put more blue in it. If you want it to be warm, you put more brown in it, or a bit of red in it. But anyway, this is for the frothy areas of water that's in here to be for the dark bit to be a bit more grey, so then we can see it. Some of our white water going down here. Okay. So I won't do too much in that water just yet, because I can save that. I can save that because I enjoy it. I might use another brush. I'll use that as my brush for that. This brush would be good for dark areas, I think. So what I might do is start blocking in all this. This. So a bit of brown, a bit of slack green. So same idea, of course. You've got to not same idea. So I want this to be darker than that background. This has got to be darker than that for this to stand out. When you do yours, you can use whatever shape you like, whatever idea. I just went for that sort of shape there. Like that. And I can have a bit of a ledge, that's the idea. old sap green. There's a bit more of the mossy area on this, so I can throw in sap green as my base colour. Some of that in the water, as it does tend to show up in places. So that's quite good. I want there's this rock here, but I don't want it to be too dark, so I just wait until a bit of light. I want it to get progressively darker the closer it is to you. It's just a little illusion. Blended together, and then over like that. Okay, now notice some sort of yellow ochre up here on the rocks, so I'll just put that in. I can see it. Tiny bit of light breaking in as well. Places. I'm not going to go too overboard with it because I don't want to take away from what I've got. That'll do. It's only like glimmers of light. Okay. So do I fill those in now? Grab some white on this brush. It's not quite the highlight yet. While we've got it, actually, we might as well start playing around with this area. Of water coming through. Get these really light lights that go. So we need some cleaner paint and more paint. So we've got this flow in here going. Some blue right here. Sort of here's where the light changes, so we can stay quite subtle in amongst this lot. It's really good fun playing water. I really enjoy it. I need more white now, I've used all of it. But while we're thinking about that, we can. We need to put that light on there. Let's do that first. There's a bit of light, a bit of yellow, maybe. Tiniest bit of sap green and cad yellow. Got some grassy tannins of it. I'm going to throw in a bit of yellow ochre in this as well. Bit of sap green in it. A bit of a might use my detail knife to put a little bit of this rock colour. Here and there there's a sort of a bit of rock. Here. There's not much paint on there. Quick way of getting some rocks in there. Like there. But there as well. do me. That'll do me. I want to create that. There's a bit of a... Leave that because we don't want that to be too distinct, really. No, we want to make it carried away. We start doing all these little details, and I haven't blocked this in yet. Let's block this in now. Probably thinking, well, Jason, you said that you you work the whole painting like making a cake, and but you went and spent a lot of time doing the details, and you didn't bake the cake. You even had highlights there. Well, I can get away with that one because I did that because of the because I knew. That I need to put this dark in front of that, so I don't mind that one. But you're right, all that detail over there I could have waited, but I got so carried away. Started to enjoy myself, and that brush, it just wouldn't stop, it just kept on going. Anyway, let's block this in. You could block this in with anything, you could use a big brush. You don't mind cleaning them. I hate cleaning brushes. So that's just the reason why I use these brushes. I know they're a bit smaller than some. They work. They do work. I'm going to grab some slack green, but it's cool now. Pretty yellow kind of well. Okay, so we've got all that.
that blocked in pretty quickly.
So I'm on a part two now because I went and had a drink. Sometimes you just have to have a bit of juice to keep you going. I'm talking about fruit juice. I'm in training at the moment. I don't want anything else other than healthy food. Say healthy food. I meant to say healthy drinks. I'm not much of a drinker anyway. Right, so I'm trying to brighten up this area. I want my smaller brush as well, because there's some light bits in the background. Just to show you this, because I'm painting where I'm wet, there's two ways to get your paint to stick to other paint. One is you'll hear them saying a thin paint will stick to a thicker paint, but also a load of paint will stick to paint as well. So if you really load the brush, I'll show you how loaded that is. It focuses. I'm not sure if it's going to focus on that one. It's not going to focus, is it? But anyway, it's loaded full. Full on. Imagine a cheeseburger with extra 10 extra slices of cheese. Goes on. Okay, here it's going. It's just coming over there, splashing down, something like that. And we'll go to there, and then. And then it gets darker. It's interesting how that's worked, isn't it? It looks good. I like it anyway. I think it looks good. What I'm thinking in this background, I want a little bit more of the cerulean blue. I think it's lacking a bit of that.
drops. Now we're back into this sort of duller colour. All this could come in. Thinking about water. Okay, quite a bit of movement there now, quite like that. Going quiet and just painting. Just painting. Yeah. Okay. So that'll do me. That'll do me for now. There's a lot of movement in there. I don't want to overdo it. Adding a bit of a splash there. Bit of a background splash. Okay, quite like that so far. We've got a tree here we need to put in. I might use this little brush. Get it started. Or maybe I'll get it started with the just get it going really quick. It's the old filbert brush, good idea. Good. Just throw my brush, leave the white on it, I'm not too bothered. Throw it into some the yellow. And do little flicks.
There's plenty of ways to paint leaves and things. And this is just one. The trick is, again, put loads of paint on your brush. Loads of paint. Do it. For a little bit of dark on that then. Yeah, quite like that. Background branches. Alright, I'll leave that, I think. Light might brighten up a cool there. Like really bright. Might catch a couple. Not all of it though, so I'll do. And now need holding loads of brushes now. Now I need to start lightening up one of these sides. I'm going to use a bit of red and this blue. Some rock areas like this here. So I don't want too much detail in these at all. It was really dark and dull. Might do the old knife trick again. So you just pull it out flat and then cut across and roll the paint. And lightly, 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 lightly. Red in it now. Just making changes in the colour, really. That's the only reason I did that. Get some green, green and blue, green and blue. Maybe a touch lighter. Sap green, and the blue. Keep this really dark though, really dark. Maybe I can have a bit jutting out there. Why not? We can do it, we might as well. It's giving it quite a lot of shape now, really. Let's block that in there. That shows how light that is now to this. It's all starting to develop. I'm starting to get excited, actually. Right, let's get a brush. Just gonna wipe my brushes. I'm just doing the. Added something, just added, trust me. Added something. What do you mean? No, it didn't. Didn't make any difference. Yeah, it made a massive difference. It really did. Right, let's I want to remember what I was doing other than painting myself. Oh. So here. Something I have this. I had a bit of light. Coming across onto here. Just a gap in the rock or something that's just... Let's get a few of them. Okay. A bit of yellow ochre. There's a few. Who knows what they are? Maybe they're like little bits of root or something. But I did paint them on the other one, so might as well put them in. Something else I did is I kind of built this up and like that. You can do all kinds of things, can't you, really? Amazing what you can do. Got a bit of a ledge there now. Not there, though. Don't like that. Right, now, we've got some... some stuff growing on here. Who knows what's growing in there? But one thing we do know is we've got a couple of really bright ones. I'm just putting a lot of random marks in here. A bit different colours. I really just wanted this area a bit brighter. So then we get another layer, you see. So we've got layers and layers and layers. So I think we're pretty much done, actually.
Yeah, I don't want to get rid of too much of the... That'll do. Sit back, have a look at that. Yeah, I quite like that. It's got a lot of movement, which is what I wanted. I'm tempted to put a... So I was out walking. It was really weird. I saw this bird, but I didn't see it until the light hit underneath it as it sort of lifted itself up. So maybe I could do something like that. So when the bird sort of light. Underneath it. Yeah, that kind of works. Kind of. Might as well put another one in if I'm going to do one. I'll put three in and make one of them really faint. But yeah, you could just see that sort of light underneath the bird, and I was like, whoa, totally didn't know it was there. No, I didn't want to do that. Same goes. Right. Yeah, I think we'll call this one finished. Really enjoyed myself doing this one. I mean, I could keep going, I know I could, but... Once I get going, it's hard to stop. But I think we're about there. I think we are. So, thanks very much for watching this one. I think I'll give it a JB down this side. A bit of paint. JB down there. So yeah, thanks very much for watching this one. I'm going to go wash my hands and my t-shirt. And I'll see you in another one. Cheers, bye.